Hello dear, in this video we are going to discuss about what is the role of lexical analyzer. So lexical analyzer is the first phase of compiler and it reads the source program each character by character until a meaningful token is formed. Like whenever it reads a keyword, it has to recognize it as a keyword. And similarly, when it reads an identifier, a variable, it has to recognize it as an identifier. So this lexical analyzer takes source code, read alphabet by alphabet until a meaningful information is formed. So once it recognizes it as an identifier or something, it returns that as an output. That is your token. Okay, so the input is a source code and output is a token. And in general, what happened, like whenever like this is accompanied, this lexical analyzer is accompanied by a symbol table. See, whenever it reads an identifier, it has to check whether the identifier already exists in the symbol table or not. Like when you are reading a character, like when you are reading an identifier as sum, we have to check whether the sum is already encountered in the program. So it checks in the symbol table whether the entry for the sum is already made. If it is already made, we are going to return that index position. Like it will be, like if it is stored in the symbol table at the fifth position, then you are going to return id comma 5. Okay, so this is called a token. This is token. Id is a token and this is an attribute that actually specifies something, some information regarding this identifier. Okay, so this lexical analyzer goes hand in hand with the symbol table. And again, like this is a general description that is given for a lexical analyzer, but the usual structure is like both lexical analyzer and syntax analyzer works then and there. It is not like that, like lexical analyzer takes the entire code, convert it into a set of tokens and give to a syntax analyzer. It is not a case like this. So each time when a lexical analyzer recognizes a token, it sends it to syntax analyzer. And once syntax analyzer parses it for its parsing and all, after that it will send a get next token. So then only lexical analyzer will read the next token. Okay, so it is like it is not like two different phases, both goes hand in hand. Okay, the reason why we have different phases for lexical, since that both are going in phases like hand by hand, we can't say that both are same phases. Like it has a different function and it has a different function. Why we have differentiated both the things is like one, like it has a purpose, like it generates, reads the source code and convert it into set of tokens, and syntax analyzer takes the token and derive a parse tree. In order to make the simplicity of your design, we have a two different phases for lexical analyzer and syntax analyzer. Okay, so this will improve the efficiency of compiler too. Okay, and similarly, like when you are using, like when the portability of this can be improved by using the different lexical analyzer and same syntax analyzer. Okay, so these are all the advantage of splitting a lexical analyzer separately than the syntax analyzer. And the remaining works for a lexical analyzer is, as I told you, it reads the source code and converts the source code into token. And the another role of your lexical analyzer is it will remove all the white spaces, tab spaces in the program. And also another role of lexical analyzer is it keep track of the line number. See, whenever an error occur, like it will come along with this line, you have an error, right? So that error, like in attaching a line number along with the error function, so that is done by this lexical analyzer. Okay, so these are all the role of lexical analyzer, and we'll discuss about the errors of lexical analyzer in the next video. Thank you.